question the efficacy of hearers being able to leave the country. While I'm not misogynist, we must agree that the Most High that you call God is a patriarch. He created a man and gave him dominion over everything, inclusive of the woman. What happened? It's called liberal democracy. The church effeminate, the political bodies effeminate, and now America effeminate? No, I think not. He later created a woman for a man in Genesis 2 and 18. It is clear from the Bible that the creator is patriarchal. And if you're contrary to that, you're anti-Christ, anti-Adonai, and you have the devil's vibration, which is the wicked patriarch of Cain, not the righteous one of Abel. Eve betrayed her creator and her husband for selfish pride. Those that will vote for Hera's suffers the curse of Eve. Eve wanted to rule like the man, so she yielded to the devil. The man was made in the image and likeness of his creator. The woman was made in the image and likeness of the man. So she yielded to the devil. And because of her, we all die. Sirach 25 and 24, 1 Timothy 2 and 14. A church or a political body in which the influence of women is not checked by masculine rule, where indeed it is instead elevated and amplified, will always descend into mystical, emotional chaos. We exist to please Adonai. It is impossible to build true religion on the false assumption of the opposite. Unfortunately, even pious women, even though you may see Kamala Harris as a pious woman, giggle, giggle, even pious women tend to lead us in the opposite direction if unchecked. And impious women? Perhaps that's more fitting to Kamala Harris. After all, she did have Megan Thee Stallion at her speech. And impious women, immodest ones, only accelerate the move, because they are all about glorifying themselves. If you think Kamala Harris should run the country, not only must you women admit that you're anti-Bible, anti-Yah, anti-Christ, and anti-American. It's reminiscent to Obama being in office. You voted for him because he was black. Not because he was the best candidate, because you knew nothing about Obama. And so now it's repeating themselves, even though Kamala Harris has never identified as being black. Wait, change of face, now suddenly she's black. Because let's face it, folks, the black vote will be the deciding factor of who win the election. White votes are usually equally divided. And the other ones, yeah, but the black vote is more essential. So hearers will now play on your emotions. Will you yield to it? Will you yield to it? Will you yield to it? We must stop making emotional decisions and diminish selfish pride. If we want the truth, real truth, Trump 2024. Get out of your emotions and do the right thing. Stop making emotional decisions. Take America back.
Good morning, APEC. Good morning. What an honor. No. We must stand with Israel.
Do you support reparations for black people?
So I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to do something that's only going to benefit black people. No.
Which is why I support the United States' commitment to provide Israel with $38 billion in military assistance over the next decade.
So I'm not gonna sit here and say I'm gonna do something that's only gonna benefit black people. No.
I support full funding for Israel, including for the Arrow, David Sling, and the Iron Dome missile defense systems, which save lives.
So I'm not gonna sit here and say I'm gonna do something that's only gonna benefit black people. No.
And that's why I am fully committing to maintaining Israel's qualitative military edge.
So I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to do something that's...
When we invest in clean energy and electric vehicles and reduce population, more of our children can breathe clean air and drink clean water.
First, we've got population. The world today has 6.8 billion people. That's headed up to about 9 billion. Now, if we do a really great job on new vaccines, healthcare, reproductive health services, we could lower that by perhaps 10 or 15%.